Now let's go back to our code. So here in our index.html file, what we want to do is put an image in here. So how are we going to figure out how to use an image tag if we've never done it before? Even though I've been working with HTML for over a decade, I still forget how certain tags work and what attributes you can use in those tags. So to pull up some of the most common web resources for referencing HTML, let's do a quick Google search. So I'll create a new tab. So I'm just going to do a search for HTML image tag. And at the very top of the result list, we get an entry in w3schools.com. Now this website is very helpful to a lot of people, but it's important to mention that it's not necessarily the most up-to-date when it comes to the latest HTML specifications and recommendations. Down here at about the fourth result is developer.mozilla.org, which is the preferred HTML reference for a lot of people because it stays consistently up-to-date, and also it's run by a nonprofit organization, whereas W3Schools is a for-profit. In a practical sense, though, I find myself on w3schools.com a lot because it tends to contain better examples and is a bit easier to navigate depending on what you're looking for. So let's click on this first result, HTML image tag. So at the very top of an HTML tag page on w3schools, there's an example, and it gives you a chance to play around with the example. If you click the try it yourself button, it will open up the code inside of an HTML document and let you mess around with it. So for example, we could change the width of this image and click see result, and you'll see the change on the right-hand side. I'm going to close out this tab, and this ability is a nice feature of W3Schools. You can find it sometimes on developer.mozilla.org, but it's not as common. I'm gonna hold down the command key while I hit the back button to open up our previous page in a new tab here. This is where we searched for HTML image tag. And let's open up the developer.mozilla.org page to compare it side by side with the W3Schools. So one thing that might be immediately clear is that there are no advertisements, which is nice when you're trying to get your head into learning something. But the way that this page is organized may not put the information you're looking for at the top. This site tends to focus on the details. So for example, at the very top of the page is this usage note, and it contains some information that's a bit more advanced. So if you're just starting with HTML, it may feel a little overwhelming. Whereas over here in W3Schools, we have an example that we can work with right away, and then it gives us some additional details. So throughout the series, we're going to use a mix of these two sites, depending on what it is that we're looking for. So what we're mostly concerned with is the syntax. So it looks like it's IMG for the image tag. There's no closing tag, it's just an opening tag. This is called a void element, and you'll see several examples of this as we go through the series. We can identify the source file with the SRC, or source property. The alt will come into play a little bit later when we talk about accessibility, but it gives this an alternative text for screen readers. So anybody who can't see the image will see this text instead. And then we can set a height and a width. The only property we really need to include this time is the source property, because this image is just being used for us for a reference for the design. So let's jump back to our code and let's add an image tag here. Another advantage to using an IDE instead of a plain text editor is that you get suggestions like this. Like, what properties do we want to use inside of this image tag? And source, which is required, shows up at the top. So let's just hit enter. This is also looking in the directory that we're currently using for any files that we could use inside of this source, and qualities heading is one. I'm gonna double click that, and then we'll end the tag. I'm gonna save this, and then I'll jump back to our browser and go back to the example page and refresh, and we see our image right here. Now we can get started trying to match this up with some HTML.